Hey YouTube fam, it's your girl Gladys, aka Zat Your Hair, and welcome back to my channel. So, today is a special day, you guys. Today's Beyonce's birthday.
Ooh, boy, you're looking like you like what you see.
Today's Beyonce's birthday. To honor the queen, I wanted to bring you this Beyonce-inspired hair. So this feels by Sensational, and it's their latest addition to the What Lace collection. And her name is Danzy. So, quick specs on Danzy. She does come with two combs here, comb in the back, adjustable straps, and a 13x6 parting area. Now, if you are new to wigs or maybe just unfamiliar with the Wet Lace collection, it received a lot of hype, a lot of buzz on the YT due to the supernatural hairline on this wig. Way more natural than a lot of synthetic wigs out there right now. So because of that, a lot of people have hopped on to the Wet Lace bandwagon, including myself. I've reviewed probably like 1, 2, 3, 4 of the units. Let's just jump right into the pros of Danzy. The first pro for me for Danzy is this gorgeous texture. Now, I know you saw what I was dealing with in the beginning of the video. Danzy obviously did not come like this. She was longer and she was bigger. Me personally, it was overwhelming. I typically like my kinky curly units to be a little bit shorter with a little less volume. I already knew that I would be going in with some scissors to kind of like hook Danzy up to my liking. After doing all that work, I really liked the way she came out. All the other units from the Sensational What Lace collection have been mostly of a silky texture. Kiari, which I did review, check out that unit, it'll be in the cards above. That unit was a more yaki texture, and a lot of people seem to like that. And this one is the first kinky curly unit from the series, so I was really hype about that, and I was ready to just jump right on it. For me, that's the main pro, the texture. Another pro to this unit is, of course, the hairline. Now, you look here, I did my best to blend it. I'm still learning the whole lace front thing, but I think I did a pretty okay job. This unit does come with baby hairs. I'm not using them right now, but they're there for your use. Another pro to this unit is the parting area. I think it looks really natural. It does mimic how my hair looks after I do a twist out and I take it out and it's fluffed out and it, you know, kind of puffs up here at the top and then kind of cascades down into these layers. It mimics natural hair, and I think having this type of parting space makes it look a lot more believable. As far as this color, I'm loving this color. Before I started getting into all the bright colors, a true 30 was my favorite blonde color, period. I just love the way the 30 tone looks on my skin tone. It's also considered a honey blonde, and I think it looks especially good in kinky curly hair on me. So I'm totally happy that I chose this color for this unit. Now we all know the main con to these Wet Lace collections is the lace color. In my other videos, I have shown you a few ways to tint, darken, whatever you want to call it, the lace. In my Kiari video, I showed you how to tint the lace using Rit dye. Also, I've shown you in my video where I reviewed Audrey how to darken the lace with just like foundation, pressed powder. This time, I ain't like doing all that. It's late. This is how it looks like when I record at nighttime, and I just wasn't in the mood. So I just laid it down with the Got to Be Glue free spray and the gel. This time, I used my powder from my Juvia's Place palette to blend it, and I think that worked really well. I think that worked really well, so I think I'm gonna continue doing that henceforth if I have to deal with lace that is that light again. So I'm really enjoying Danzy. I think she looks super cute. I love how I cut her to frame my face. I've gotten a few questions about cutting kinky curly hair, and just to give a few tips, the first tip I would give is to, one, just assess the wig, put it on your head. See how it falls on your face. When I cut my kinky curly wigs to my face, I like when there are shorter pieces here in the front and it, you know, gradually gets longer towards the bottom. But in the spirit of Beyonce, I was like, let me leave it a little bit longer for you, girl. I think Beyonce would approve what you think. Definitely, you know, try to cut in like a, I don't know, I guess you could say like a V shape. Yeah, I guess like a V shape. Also, when you are cutting, I wouldn't take a strand and start cutting so high up. I do that sometimes because I've been cutting curly wigs for a while and, you know, I'm not too stressed about if I cut something too short or not. But if it's your first time or you're still new to it, just cut as low to the bottom as you can, just so you can gauge how the hair is falling. Kinky curly hair is very deceiving. There's shrinkage. When you pull this out, you might think that this is gonna land you right here, and then next thing you know, the curl is up here. And then you're like trying to fluff it out for days. Those are just two tips that I have when it comes to cutting kinky curly hair. Last tip would be just to be patient, because like for me to do this took at least 30 minutes. I'm a perfectionist when it comes to cutting kinky curly hair. So I will go in as much as I deem fit in order I get the results that I want. And I suggest that you do the same, because I feel like, you know, cutting curly wigs to frame your face definitely makes it look a lot more natural. On to another, I don't know if I would say, kind of a con thing about this unit is the price point. It is definitely in the high price range of synthetic wigs. I understand why it's higher, because you're paying for this hairline, you're probably paying for the amount of hair on the unit and so forth, and the curl pattern. However, I've seen cheaper units that deliver similar results, if not the same result. The wig Showstopper by Sensational, that wig has the same texture and you could cut it the exact same way, and it's at a much cheaper price point. Like, we're talking in the 20s. You know, if you want to experiment with cutting your curly wigs, I suggest starting with something that's a little bit lower, so that in case you do make a mistake or two, you don't feel as bad, because you're like, oh my God, this wig costs like $60. You know what I mean? Now, would I pay $55 or $60 for her? No, I wouldn't. Because I've had other curly, kinky curly wigs that are cheaper that I can do the same thing to. No, it may not have such a natural hair parting. It's not gonna have this natural hairline. But normally for me, when I'm wearing kinky curly wigs like this, I'm not showing my hairline. I'm not really worried about it. So to each his own. Please let me know how you feel about Danzy in the comments down below. How do you like this color choice, this texture? Am I serving Beyonce vibes or not? I think I am. Actually, Beyonce would have this hair longer, but I think for the way it came, this length was suitable for me. I like her, she's cute. And also, make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. We did reach 2,000 subscribers recently, which I'm super happy about. Thank you so, so much. If you would like to see more reviews from the Wet Lace collection, they will be to the left of me, to the right of me, they're around me. I have a few now, so let me know your thoughts. Thank you so, so much for watching. I love you guys so much, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.